Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Let's Play Dark Souls. So in the last episode, well, the last story-based episode anyway, we defeated the Hydra of Ash Lake, and now we're going to do a little bit of exploring for the rest of Ash Lake, but there's not really a whole lot more to see. So as we come over this sandy, or, you know, probably ashy beach, because obviously that is the namesake, you'll see that there's like a tree trunk over here, and then if you've got like really good vision, or this video turns out in really high quality, you might be able to see some of those clams over there, and those clams are the same ones that we fought in the Crystal Caves before Seath. And they actually have the same drops. I've totally forgotten what this item is. Dragon Scale. Okay, so there's a lot of Dragon Scales here. And that's awesome, particularly if you're still someone who's using the Drake Sword or another Dragon-type weapon. Probably, it depends what you do, Ash Lake, but a lot of people would still be using the Drake Sword by this point. And that kind of fits in with the lore of Ash Lake. I think that guy's sleeping, so we'll just try to fight one at a time. As always. And of course, remember if you recall from the opening cutscene, the narrator mentions, you know, before the Age of Fire. I forget what it was called before the Age of Fire. It might have been the Age of Dragons, but anyway. Come on, get over here. I should really be using my Quelaag's Fury Sword right now because I have enough humanity to make it, like, really, really useful. Do I have that equipped on my other spot? No, I have Pyromancy equipped on my other slot. This should not be taking me as long as it is. These guys seem harder than the ones in Seath Slayer. I'll get back to that lore discussion in a second. And again, this comes up now and then. People ask, hey Northernlion, who's that YouTuber that you recommended that does the Dark Souls lore videos? Epic name bro. Epic name bro. Go check him out, it's awesome. What do we have here? Twinkling Titanite, excellent. Probably the first time I've ever said that without messing it up. And we might as well kill this guy as well, because remember, those Twinkling Titanites are an 8,000 soul value. Now for the low, low price of, you know, potential death. Really good to have the rusted iron ring equipped here. Yeah, this does do a little bit more damage. Because it'll allow us to fight on the water without actually losing much mobility. Any mobility, perhaps. I can't remember. I should not have taken that hit. That was dumb. Oh, Lord. They almost one-hit comboed me. He might one-hit combo me. Clam Man, don't be so much of a dick, really. I should probably get more than an Estus plus one. It's gonna take me three if I want to heal back to full. Oh well. Let's go to town on him now. Two hits should stagger him. We can pretty much stun lock him. We don't need to though. Okay. And these are the last enemies we're gonna face in here. Surprised to not get a drop from him. These guys usually have really high drop rates. Alright, anyway, in the opening cutscene, the Age of Dark or the Age of Dragons, I can't remember. They mentioned everything was just like ash and arch trees and everlasting dragons. So, that is pretty much the area we're dealing with right here, which explains why there's so many dragon scales. This is like the bottom of the earth. The way I like to think of this area is that it's like where the Age of Dragons ended. It's like their last bastion, if you will. But again, if you want some more discussion on lore, I'm probably not the person to give it to. You probably want to check out Epic Name Bro there. Now, this is actually kind of a tricky part. There's not much more to see in Ash Lake, and we'll probably do something else this video. Oh, there's another clam. I totally forgot about this jerk-off. Alright, we'll take this guy out and we'll continue discussing. But we're in a risky part. Let's just hit this guy with some pyromancy. Ba-bam! Wow, that worked pretty well, actually. Did it kill him? Yes, it did. Alright, two great chaos fireballs. We're Twinkling Titanite. Fair trade. The area we're walking on here is dangerous because you can see that it drops off fairly quickly, particularly on the left side, it looks like. So we're just gonna, you know, I'll take it a little bit slow through here because the Ash Bridge does get pretty tiny. And then I'll show you one of the other covenants, which is contained in the bottom of Ash Lake. And I'll do my best to explain it, even though I'm not 100% familiar with the mechanics. I have a basic understanding, I think, of how it works. Through here, there should be no more enemies, at least if I recall. Now, there is a pretty baller weapon if you get a strength build. So we'll just make our way through here, just noticing like the ambiance, if you can actually see like another area from here, it doesn't look like. But of course, like, the cool thing about going down through the Great Hollow is that when you come back, or when you get to Ash Lake, you can see all these other arch trees. You see, like, whoa, there's probably, like, dozens of great hollows, quote-unquote. So So we got a big-ass dragon here, and we have a bonfire. And as you probably remember, there is a bonfire next to pretty much every covenant. This is going to make it really easy for us to warp out of here. So this is the Path of the Dragon Covenant. I'm not actually going to join it, so I'm not going to pray to the Everlasting Dragons. But I am going to come back here, cut this dude's tail off, because he just don't give a shit. This gives us the Dragon Greatsword. Okay, good, he doesn't give a shit. Let's check out the Dragon Greatsword in our inventory. I believe you need 50 strength to use that, which is something that I will never have over the course of this entire game, that's for damn sure. There's a Dragon Greatsword, probably up here. There we go. Oh, it's right above Quaalog's Fury Sword. Durr. Yeah, it requires 50 strength, but you can see it does 390 physical damage right out the start, which is crazy. But yes, I will never be able to use that because there is absolutely no chance of me getting to 50 strength. And that is pretty much Ash Lake in a nutshell. It's a cool area for the lore of the game and, like, the, again, ambiance of the game. Not so much gameplay-wise apart from the Hydra and the Covenant. I'll explain the Covenant as we travel to Anor Londo here. Because I am going to try to do some of the Painted World this video. So the Path of the Dragon Covenant, if you join that, let me think for a second. It's an invasion covenant, kind of similar to, like, the Dark Moons or the Dark Wraiths. And what happens there? Oh, what's the rest of this bonfire? I forgot that I hadn't killed her yet. Basically, you can invade people using the, I believe it's called like a dragon eye or something similar to that. And if you can only invade people who have a dragon scale, and they have to kind of agree to a duel. So it might be a soapstone, it might not be an invasion. And then when you duel, the winner gets a dragon scale and I believe like 10,000 souls, or enough souls relative to the level of the person that you beat, if that makes any sense. You also get some cool kind of sorceries, I guess you could call them. Transmutations. You can, there's a dragon head sorcery you can get that allows you to breathe, like, lightning slash fire. There's a dragon torso thing that you can get that gives you claws, and you can pretty much walk around just looking like a half-human, half-dragon. Not very popular, at least among people who play online, because it's unlikely that you're going to be able to find somebody to invade with a dragon scale. I mean, most people, when they play, at least for the first few times, just use their dragon scales to upgrade their drake sword. And there's nothing wrong with that. Like, each one gives you like a 10% boost to its attack power. But like, dragon scales are A, not very common, and like B, also used pretty quickly when they're discovered, by most people anyway. I mean, I have like 6 dragon scales in my inventory right now. The other thing is that dragon scales predominantly found, not sure if I should say predominantly, but there's a lot of them found in Ash Lake, which, you know, a lot of players don't actually go to Ash Lake because they don't discover the Great Hollow because of those two illusory walls. So we are coming through this area here. These enemies are called the Painted Guardians. I've already done this area once. Oh good, I've aggroed 3 of them at the same time. Perfect. We'll just try to take out this one guy first. Yeah, Estus up, you big dickhole. We've come through this area once before, but we couldn't actually get to the painting because I didn't have the peculiar doll yet. This guy's probably healing too. What a jerk off. There's a bonfire coming up very soon, so I don't have to worry too much about losing Estus. Yeah, so now that we do have the peculiar doll, we can actually examine the painting, which will allow us to enter a new world where there's a lot of items there. And I actually am not a huge fan of the painted world. I find the enemies in it needlessly difficult a lot of the time. But we'll see how it works out. It's a totally optional area. Aesthetically, gorgeous, gorgeous place. Completely different from any area that we come across in Dark Souls. Oh, come on. I was just trying to heal up like you guys. I wanted to be cool. He's dead. One more. And I think one more near the painting. But, you know, that's not a huge deal. Alright. These guys don't inflict bleed, which is nice. Because otherwise, I might actually be in some trouble here. Just doing, like, random hacks and slashes. Getting a lot of throwing knives from these guys, which is nice, I guess. I'll probably never use those because I don't have a slot for them, really. I think there's one dude chilling over here, yeah, by where we got the Black Iron Great set. Or Black Iron Armor set, I should say. There we go, just cut him up with a two-hander. Excellent, so now we will enter the Painted World, an area I've only done once before. That's some Page Master shit right there. Anyway, a couple things to note about the painted world of Ariamis. I have not mentioned yet in this video, and I'm sure people are going to comment about it. You need the peculiar doll to get to the painted world. The way you get the peculiar doll is by going to the Undead Asylum again. So go back and watch the video that's called, like, Return to the Undead Asylum. That will help you out a great deal. The other thing is, once you enter the painted world, you can't leave. I can't actually warp out of here with my Lord Vessel. Yeah. So, once we're in here, we're basically stuck. But it's not super difficult, it's just kind of annoying. And I should actually preface this entire video by saying, or like the next two videos maybe, by saying that I'm not by any means an expert on this area. I haven't looked at any walkthroughs or guides for this area, so I don't know where any of the items are, or most of the items are, let's put it that way. But I do know that we're really going to want to open this door at some point so that we can get a shortcut. Now, the most annoying enemies that you'll come across here... Why are we getting some frame rate issues? I don't like that. Could reverse hollowing and kindle that bonfire. You know, I'm going to reverse hollowing and kindle that bonfire. It's going to make me, like, highly prone for invasions, but that's kind of cool. This is a big PvP area, mostly with the red sign soapstone as far as I know, but also, you know, you do get invaded fairly frequently at the Painted World. At least the one time I was here, I got invaded a few times. Lucky enough to actually win those invasions, believe it or not. Sometimes it's better to be the host if you're comfortable with PvP, because you know the people invading you are invading up. So you've got to be a higher level than them. Just deal with these hollows. One hit him. Am I doing less damage or more damage here with this Quelaag's Fury Sword? I never remember if it's humanity, like just the soft humanity you have in your top left corner, or if you actually have to be human to bank on those humanity as well. I'm just going to try to remember. We have the most annoying enemy on Earth, not this guy. I mean, these archers with their homing arrows are pretty annoying sometimes. What is going on here? Why is the frame rate so fucking slow? What just happened there? Game went down to like 2 frames a second. Good thing I healed my Estus anyway. There's one guy. Bro number 2 is probably coming down. Row number 3 with the arrows, and then there's a third arrow, bro. Come on, man. Fight fair. Thought he was gonna actually hit me with that one. Do we have something back here? I don't think I've ever explored back here. Nope. But, oh, maybe. Oh, God. What just shot fire at me? This is, oh, okay, that's the most annoying enemy in the game coming at me right now. Fucking hate this guy right here. When you murder him, he explodes. He's like a cursed hollow. I'm gonna try to take him out with pyromancy, because that allows me to get at like a distance. That was a good throw. And of course, he has like 1 hit point left. So just back the fuck up and get away from that explosion. Oh my god, enemies! I'm just trying to make my way here. Maybe this is the right way, I can't remember. Now we're on top of here and seemingly nothing to get. Oh, except for this. What is this? Dried finger. Okay, that's for another... Oh, God! It's for another covenant, I think, but I can't remember which one. We'll take a look at that item description in a second. Thought I saw another hollow up there. Now, I've already taken a different path than I did the first time I came through this area, so I'm pretty much lost already. But that's cool, you know, mix things up a little bit. Alright, another one of these toxic undead. Least favorite enemy in the history of life. Making the frame rate get all horrible. Please stop that. From Software. Did a very, you know, diligent job with this game. Don't make them look like fools. Okay, Soul of a Proud Knight. Oh, what a- arrows! I fucking hate you guys! I feel like I'm resorting to, like, noob LP or traps here by yelling all the time, but I'm pissed off. This is basically the first time I've ever done like a semi-blind area in Dark Souls, so maybe this is... I have a little bit more respect for those people who play through the game blind, even if it does take them 45 minutes to get, or 45 episodes to get past the Taurus demon. You know who you are. These guys, when they explode, cause toxic, I think, or poison, I can't remember which, and they also cause you to need to repair your weapons, if I remember. Oh my god, the fire breathing dickholes. It's always good to come to this area when you're a little bit overpowered, I find. At least for me. Yeah, I get it. You're a hollow. Big deal. We've all got problems, buddy. Don't want to fall down there, certainly. I've never been to this area before, so we do have... No, there's no way I'm going to be able to get over there. Well-executed jumping puzzle? That would be the only way that I could first... Oh my god! Get out of here! This is my spot! This is why I need to play with sound on. And of course we have another one. Let's hit him up with some fire orb action. I'm really glad that these guys are not exploding. But they are kind of creeping me out when I walk over their big ball sacks. Okay. Am I safe for a second? Can I look at the dried finger? Let's do that. Oh, there it is. The very bottom. Awesome. I want to see the description. Dried finger with multiple knuckles. Shriveled but still slightly warm. I've forgotten what that does. I'll get back to you on that one. Let's put it that way. Alright, now we do have some new enemies that we'll meet as we come up this staircase, if I remember correctly. These enemies are called harpies. They're basically like half crow, half woman, and 100% dead. Yep. I thought maybe it might live, because, you know, it has wings and it's like a crow, but I suppose not. I don't know what that attack does. Oh god! I thought it was just showing me its genitals. These guys actually- Oh, bad! That's bad! I lived? I fucking lived. I don't believe it. Choke that Estus, boy. I don't want to go to that fog wall yet, I think. What about this door? Did this door open? I always forget which way I'm supposed to be going in this area. I think I might have found a shortcut, even though it nearly cost me my entire life. Here. Is this the phalanx area? Yes, it is. Okay. Ignore these douchebags. You guys are annoying as hell. And I don't want to deal with you. And you're making my frame rate go crazy. One thing I cannot tolerate. We're going to pop open this door and go to the bonfire right away. Guy's like, it looks like he's still breathing. So we'll go rest here. So we've opened up that shortcut, essentially. It might not seem like we've done a lot, but for me, it feels like we have. Can't believe I haven't bought a repair box. I really need to go back to Andre and get one of those. ASAP. Come down here. Murder these hollows, as we always do. Man, 190,000 souls. I should probably... I'm trying to think. Actually, you know, it might not be useful for me to do anything with those. Maybe we'll level up before we fight the final boss. So these guys right here are called the Phalanx. They defend that statue, but I don't really have any interest in dealing with them because it takes 45 minutes. They're kind of annoying. What we are going to do is check out this area over here. I think some hollows will start to climb up. Whoa, lots of them! Get out of there! And I always forget about that goddamn archer on the top. Sterling Mallory Archer! Stop shooting arrows at me, even though it's your namesake. That's the kind of highbrow humor you can expect if you subscribe to Northernlion's channel. Now for the low, low price of only $39.95. 5 active humanity. I'm kind of surprised I haven't been invaded yet. Is this the way I want to go if I want to get raped by bone wheel skeletons? Yes, it is. I don't want to get raped by bone wheel skeletons, so we're going to ignore going down there. Now, you might be thinking that you have to go down there, even if you've played the game before, because they kind of make it seem like you do. But you don't. You can actually get out of it much more easily. Now, this is locked by some contraption, and I've never been able to open this door. Which I know, it's going to piss a lot of people off, because... This video in general is going to piss a lot of people off, I mean, because... Just looking for enemies. I know I'm missing a lot. Let's put it that way. But, I would like to say that... I actually just don't know what I'm doing through this area. Maybe it's a nice change of pace for you to see me going through an area basically blind. Kind of blind. What are these guys doing? You're working on your delts? I guess I haven't been over here because I haven't picked up this item yet. Oh, or maybe I just don't care because it's a large soul of a proud knight, which is literally worthless to me at this point. Alright, dickholes. You can hang out there. I'm going to go up here because there is an important item up here. harpies are kind of annoying. I guess if we can just knock them off, it doesn't matter then. Thank God they've got wings, right? What's this guy doing? Now, yep, I was pretty much positive that he was just going to fall to his death. I'd be very surprised if his pathfinding was good enough to get up the stairs without falling. I think there's two more harpies up here. Should probably just use my Great Chaos Fireball on them. It won't kill them. In fact, it doesn't even do that much damage. It did about half. These guys are stronger than I remember. I wonder what weapon I had last time I came through here. I think we have one more, and then a pretty popular item up here at the top. Although I've never gotten much of a chance to really use it. Crow's out of the way, try not to fall down the staircase. There we go. Red Sign Soapstone. So this allows us to do like mutual consenting PvP, basically. We put our Red Sign Soapstone on the ground, and then other people in their world can see it, and they can summon us for a duel. So it's kind of meant to be like the classier version of PvP, because you're not actually just actively forcing yourself into someone's world. I've never used it, but I have seen some Red Sign Soapstones on the ground. I've just never had a chance myself to actually summon them. So you can see there's a big dickhole dragon here. But we are going to save that for the next video, because it might take me, you know, 5 to 10 minutes to actually deal with him. Kind of annoying. As always, thank you guys for watching Let's Play Dark Souls. We are getting near to the end, but we have at least two more videos left of the story. Got Painted World, then we'll probably just go straight to Killing of the First Flame. Also, I will continue to make Dark Souls videos for PvP and invasions and stuff whenever the mood strikes me. It seems like you guys like those. I like making them. Invading's a lot of fun. So, yeah. As always, thanks for watching, thanks for your support, and I will see you next time.